not a vlog. I will build up a little bit on what Nils explained on why CF is needed for industry, for companies. So your perspective was more from the view of the big companies, while we represent the digital SMEs. So, and this is a slightly different case. So it's one of the things that brochure explains. It's actually why SMEs, the small companies, actually need to use the CF. Because in big companies' case, yes, it's to map, to clearly understand what do we have inside of the company, what competence, and so on. What is the implication for SMEs? I would say four main ones. So first of all, it's of course same self-assessment to understand what competences do we have in company. And this is much more important in the case of SMEs than in the big industry. Why? Because in the big companies we have clear roles, very hierarchical structure, and clear work definitions. Who does what, it's more or less clear. In SME, a human is mainly the biggest asset. And this human, every single employee and worker, has a variety of competences. It's mostly somebody very dynamic, very flexible, and that's exactly what makes European SMEs so agile and so interesting for investment, and that drives them forward, that makes them champions. So this is an asset, but it's also sometimes really hard in the company to understand, so what are the competences that we have inside? So one of the ways to use the CF is the self-assessment, to understand what we have and to also identify the gaps, what we are maybe missing. The second use of the CF is, of course, understanding the training. And obviously that small companies not always have money to invest into expensive trainings. And a lot of employees are actually self-trained. They do the most of the training on a job. They use forums. They use coders, blogs. And they do get some kind of competences. So, but we don't know. We cannot describe in this common language what did they learn and what they know if they do not refer to ECF. That establishes the language that makes them to understand themselves what we have and what further training we need. And it does not necessarily need to be something within the formal education training. It can be something what we learned by doing, but we need to understand what we need to learn and what we have already learned. The third potential use and actual use of ECF is, of course, to know who we need to hire, so for recruitment and for outsourcing, because SMEs outsource really a lot and much more than big companies. We really need to outsource a lot, and that's where the problem comes. A CEO does not, or manager, or whoever it is in a small company, does not always know what exactly do I need to develop this project, what competences and which outsourcing company can bring to me, as long as we do not refer to CF. And finally, most importantly, and following the discussion, ECF is also an opportunity for new business models. It's an opportunity for increasing the competitiveness. How? One of the examples has been given to providing consultancy to others. The other thing is that it helps attract the clients when I can come and say, this is my portfolio, these are the competences that I have within my company, therefore I can provide the best service. This becomes clear for the client. Of course, we need to develop knowledge of ECF and develop the knowledge of this common language. Maybe we need certificates too. To get this recognized, but this is a way to talk to the client and to show what I can do. In addition, same could go for the public tenders. This would help SMEs to present the portfolio that they have if the public tender would use the CF language and the SME could use this. So these are four main uses that SMEs are starting to realize, and this is the framework in which, together with Small Business Standards, we developed this fantastic brochure. There are probably some outside, and you can also download it from SBS website.